Patient Safety Day here in our hospital. As you can see, this is the rig, there's the room. My doctor, running the car. Here are my colleagues. Today, it's a location for. LB is there. Okay.
Our dear hospital executives, Dr. Ahmed, Dr. Muhammad Ismail, Madame Alex, Madame Ferial, and all our dear leaders and colleagues. Hayakum Allah. Firstly, we would like to highlight our extreme gratefulness to the hospital administration who honor us by their presence. This year, celebrating safety is very special to us because of experiencing new challenges during COVID pandemic. Today, the lab will present to you all the safety initiatives throughout its journey during this pandemic. The first video show will represent to us the most important safety activities in the lab in the past 7 months, from the time the Ministry of Health announced the presence of the first COVID positive cases in Kuwait.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say,
Power's turned us.
in the motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make it explode. This is my fight song. Take back my life.
Right of them, we learn to say thanks. To care about looking after the humanistic part and the psychological part of every member of the hospital. Thank you very much.
We are giving special consideration to our patients. For example, we are conducting patient satisfactory surveys, so that we are collecting valuable information, valuable suggestions from the patients, and we are involving them in our hospital decision making.
We take care of the patient and his family through many advisory service. We have brochures for the portions of the test. We have 24 hours, 7 days advisory service through the hotline of the lab. And we have so many advisory services in our
lab. One of the most patient safety measures in our Sheikha laboratory is to ensure the accuracy of the result. And this is implemented through so many steps. First step is the proper identification of the patient. Second, to confirm the integrity of sample and collection condition validity. Third, we have a very strong internal quality control system with troubleshooting and maintenance program of our equipment. We have very strong external quality assurance program, which allow us to compare our result versus the maximum peers all over the world, which make us more confident about the accuracy of the patient result.
Out of what we have, good morning, of course. Out of what we have seen today, thank you to Noor for the nice management of the ceremony and the gathering. It makes somebody like us speechless a little bit. Sorry, it's a fact. Because, you know, we have done some job in the hospital at our level to help, support, guide, direct, oversee, ensure that you are on the right path. But you in the field, you warriors, you were really beyond. You have shown a lot of abilities, potentials, a lot of tolerance that was really at all unexpected, at all. Without it, we could have collapsed. This is a matter of fact, I have to share with you. We have had the weeks, I think somewhere between March and April, the hospital
didn't succeed due to many factors. One of them is space limitation. Not because of your capability, not because of the equipment that we can get. We will continue to make our efforts to be number one, including this. Temporarily, we are doing that at external lab, only one lab. Until we do it here, we will work on having this done safely. And safely might need another one or two labs. We will work together on that. Merci, Dr. Morel.
Much appreciated tips.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves in motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. Might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. I'm some sleep. Everybody's worried about me. In 2D, say I'm in 2D.
We're done in our patient safety.
No, I've still got a lot of fire left in me.